Greetings.
If I was
welcome. Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning.
Get a
realistic. It's
yes.
It was radical.
Very well.
It was horrible. I'm like, you gone. This is gone way off the rails.
Sneaky finger.
It's like deja vu.
It really is like deja vu.
It's like deja vu.
Yes.
It's deja vu when I'm running up these racks. I'm like the Terminator screaming, I'll be back. It's deja vu when I'm out here flying first class. It's like every week I've gotta take out the trash. It's returning the mag, they say I'm off the rails. I can't wait for you to get it for myself. Simply this is the beat, I got plenty. Act like you did it before we start trending. Don't mistake me for a lame or a goofy. Rockstar life is like a movie. Hollywood, Hollywood, where you been? I remember when I used to drive a Fiat. Now they're looking for me like a money F. It's good to see how I keep on getting checks. This money keep on falling like it's dominoes. Special to what you think and I got a lot to blow. Feeling like I've been here before.
That's right.
Deja vu is hitting me to the core. And my beat's flashing back once more. I'm feeling like I'm living in a metaphor. Yeah.
Good morning.
It's deja vu. It's deja vu. I feel like I'm stuck in time.
Good morning.
It's deja vu. I feel like I'm losing my mind. It's deja vu. I can't escape this rhyme.
All right.
It's deja vu. It's the never ending climb. It's deja vu. When I'm running up the rest, I'm like the Terminator screaming, I'll be back. It's deja vu. When I'm out here flying first class, it's like every week I gotta take out the trash.
Good morning, ladies and ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. Good morning, Miss Boss Diva. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the morning show. You know who I am. If you don't know, let me get this out of the way. For those of you who do not know who I am, I go by the name of Zeus, or as some like to say, Triple H. And why do they call me Triple H, ladies and gentlemen? Well, it turns out because I'm the most honest person on social media. There's nobody more honest than me, all right? I promise to tell you nothing but the truth, so help me God. Oh, wait a second.
Hold on a second. Hold on. What was that? Hold on.
All right. By the way, moderators, please do not mute anybody that is a subscriber, all right? I mean, I know there's a lot of tension out there, but listen, or you know, and I see clickbait, he's not a subscriber, but don't mute him, okay? Because see, clickbait, he's broke right now and he can't afford to be a subscriber, all right? But I want to make sure I hear what he has to say so that he stops sending me these ridiculous DMs. He likes to send me nasty DMs that are full of lies, like Snuggles, all right? So don't mute Snuggles and don't mute clickbait. These are two people that I have standing arrangements with, and I want them to see me and experience me and you in all of our glory, because guess what? Aren't we winning, Democrats? Aren't we winning? We're winning. All right, so the second H stands for humble, right? There's nobody more humble than me. If I get it wrong, I will be the first to apologize, all right? But it turns out I just haven't had to apologize for anything lately because, you know, when you live in truth, you really don't have to apologize for much, right? You just got to tell the truth, all right? Like my grandmother says, tell the truth and shame the devil. Good morning, Mount Negro. How are you? Happy Labor Day to all of you, by the way, if I didn't say that. And the last H, ladies and gentlemen, is because I am and will always remain the most handsome. I really am the most handsome, right? There's nobody more handsome than me. All right, so listen, ladies and gentlemen, this picture right here, I had a great chuckle when I read it because this is, to me, the best way to describe our friends on the right, especially those possessed with the MAGA-possessed demon, right? If you think the left dressed up like the right to raid the Capitol and change the election we won, you must be a special kind of stupid, right? Change the outcome of the election we won, all right? And so, MAGA, I want you to cut it out, all right? Because I am so tired of having to call you out in all of your lies. Good morning, Darktree, and good morning, Kim. All of your lies and your misinformation. It's like you wake up. What do you eat for breakfast? A bowl of lies. What do you drink for lunch? Or drink for you know, what do you drink? I mean, oh, I drink a gallon of misinformation. Yeah, that's what I'm on. I'm on the nastiest diet in the world, all right? So, MAGA, please cut it out. All right, now before we get into today's topics, ladies and gentlemen, full disclosure, you know what I gotta say. You know, what we do on this side of TikTok is we hold our friends on the right accountable for all their dirty, disgusting deeds as well as their crimes, all right? So listen, if you are a Trump supporter and you are afraid of the truth, here is your chance to leave. You can leave this live. I won't be offended. You don't got to give me, you know, any nasty feedback or anything. Just leave. Go on about your Labor Day and have a great rest of your morning, all right? But listen, you don't got to take my word for it. Listen to your leader.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave. As far as I'm concerned, if you hate our country.
Yes, do. Good morning.
If you're not happy here, you can leave. If you're not happy in the U.S., if you're complaining all the time, very simply, you can leave. You can leave right now. Come back if you want. Don't come back. It's okay, too.
Good morning.
But if you're not happy, you can leave.
Yeah, and you know where I stand, all right? I don't tolerate liars in this kingdom, all right? And as far as I'm concerned, Trump supporters, you're nothing but liars. Every time I talk to you, there's not an ounce of truth in anything that you said, all right? Nothing you said has ever been accurate. And so what we have going on here, ladies and gentlemen, is there is a standing offer. My good friend, Nutty Professor, said, I will pay for 7 Trump supporters, MAGA-possessed demonic individuals, to go to Russia. So MAGA, listen up. The offer still stands. I still haven't had one supporter take us up on the offer. But listen, we're willing to help you get to Russia, all right? We're willing to help you get to Russia. Just raise your hand, Trump supporters, if you would love for us to help get you to Russia, all right? Now here, Vladimir Putin would love to have you over there because there's nobody here forcing MAGA to stay here, all right? So you should go where you're loved and you should go where you're needed, MAGA. Nutty Professor does have money. Clickbait, again, another lie. Clickbait, you know, I'm getting real disappointed in you, clickbait. You can go to Russia, all right? Or you can go to North Korea with, you know who's up there, Kim Jong-un. You like Kim Jong-un, all right? Or better yet, MAGA, you can go to China, and you should hear what I found out they're doing in China. Let me go here and show you this real quick, Trump supporters. You know, China, you know, I wanted to make sure MAGA knows what they do over there in China, okay? This story is pretty interesting. Oh, yeah, ladies and gentlemen. So, MAGA, listen up. I'm willing to help you go here. Check this out. Look at what they're doing over there. Felt sick to my stomach. A restaurant in China was caught mixing the orange juice with tap water from the mop sink. Would you like some orange juice, MAGA? Would you like some? Right. I just want you Trump supporters to know, this is what's on the menu for you because you continue to believe lies and spread misinformation. Go on over there to China and have some of this mop water orange juice, all right? does that look delicious, April? I mean, can we get some of that for these Trump supporters? Please let us know. All right, so let's get started. Oh, wait. Oh, no, I'm going to start here. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, this is just an FYI. President Biden today on Labor Day is heading to Philadelphia for a Labor Day parade and is expected to speak about unions and their importance. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. President Joe Biden, who is often the most pro-union president in history, is heading to Philadelphia today for the annual Tri-State Labor Day parade. Doesn't this remind you of what real presidents do? I'm so glad President Biden doesn't wake up every day and cry that he's the victim of election interference by his political rivals like this other loser does every single day. I am so tired of Donald Trump and his supporters waking up day in and day out crying like some little kids. Donald Trump and his supporters, they are an embarrassment to the United States of America. I can't believe you folks call yourselves adults. You ought to call yourself a bunch of whiny babies, right? They should call themselves whiny babies. Biden today is supposed to speak about the importance of unions in the United States and how the economy is recovering from the crippling coronavirus pandemic, right? So let's, ladies and gentlemen, let's give President Biden a round of applause, because what him and Kamala Harris have done, what President Biden and Kamala Harris have done in the wake of Donald Trump's failed presidency is by far the most amazing thing we've all witnessed in our lifetime. I mean, the country was literally heading straight down to hell. Okay, and the driver, Donald Trump, was the one driving this nation down to the ground. A lot of people get out here and they're crying about their so-called 401ks. They're liars. They're liars. If they go look at their 401ks right now, those 401ks are actually 802ks, right? 802ks, thanks to President Biden, all right? Trump didn't do anything for anyone except himself. And look at that. He got himself 91 felony charges and 4 indictments. MAGA, cut it out, all right? So, yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is what Biden is doing, and I do hope all of you tune in and check out this speech that he's going to give, because it's going to be one of the best speeches he's given, you know? All right, now let's move on to our next topic, ladies and gentlemen. What do I want to... Oh, yes, ladies and gentlemen, here's my next topic. How many of you have heard about President Biden and his son, Hunter Biden, you know, being involved in some sort of corruption in Ukraine? Have any of you heard about this? You know, Biden has been, he's corrupt, him and Hunter Biden. You've heard about this? Well, one of my good friends, TJ, are you here? I thank you for tagging Zeus on Twitter, right? You tag me in all kinds of amazing things on Twitter. Ladies and gentlemen, please follow TJ, all right? Great friend of mine. This new scandal, all right? FBI agent says Rudy Kaludi Giuliani was co-opted by Russian intelligence. Don't boo me. Don't boo me. Would you rather me lie? Would you rather me lie to you, ladies and gentlemen? I kid you not. All right. A new FBI whistleblower. You know, Trump supporters, they love these whistleblowers, don't they? They love them. FBI whistleblower filed a statement asserting that Giuliani may have been compromised by Russian intelligence while working as a lawyer and advisor to Donald Trump during the 2020 campaign. What a shame. You know, it's like I've always maintained, every MAGA accusation is truly a MAGA confession. Why haven't any of you Trump supporters ever mentioned a thing about Rudy Giuliani and his so-called dirty deeds that he was doing in Ukraine? You know, these folks are trying to find dirt on President Joe Biden. They came back with nothing. Well, actually, I can't say they came back with nothing. They ended up getting Donald Trump impeached. Right? This is what happens when you choose to go down a path of evil and wickedness. You end up trying to set a trap for your enemies, but you end up falling in it yourself. Isn't that right, Click Click? So, ladies and gentlemen, this story is one I want to make sure we all pay attention to and keep an eye on, because what I have a fear about is this story might get swept under the rug, all right? I think it will. It because Rudy Giuliani, you know, we all know he has so many things going on that this might actually get swept under the rug, and people might actually forget to pay attention to what's going on. Now, what I want to make sure we all keep in mind is this. Giuliani, according to this guy, John Boomer, if you want to look this up, he was used... All right, as an asset by a Ukrainian oligarch tied to Russian intelligence and other Russian operatives for a disinformation operation that aimed to discredit Joe Biden and boost Donald Trump in the 2020 presidential race. Moreover, Buma says he was the target of retaliation within the Bureau for digging into this. What a shame.
I knew it. I knew it.
So what we got here, ladies and gentlemen, is more evidence of what Donald Trump likes to say, Russia, 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 right? I mean, if you still are out there trying to say there was no collusion with Russia, I want you to know you are a liar, all right? And I don't want to hear a thing from you. I keep uncovering more and more evidence, and the key word is evidence, that Donald Trump always seems to have some sort of connection with Vladimir Putin, directly or indirectly. I mean, has anyone looked at his platform Truth Social lately? I'm pretty sure, as a matter of fact, I know, that funding for that social media platform, probably, I would give it 90% of the money came from Vladimir Putin himself. We all know that Donald Trump is an enemy of the United States. He tried to overthrow our government. His henchmen, Rudy Giuliani, Rudy Giuliani, were all part of the effort to prevent President Biden from ever becoming president. And they failed miserably. All right. And now they're getting held accountable because we all know exactly what they did. All right. But it didn't stop there. I mean, this corruption going on with the former president is corruption I've never, ever witnessed, ladies and gentlemen. So before I move on to our next topic, let's all give Rudy Giuliani his daily dose of booze and shame. And let's give Click Click his booze and shame as well, because he's in on it.
Get him out of here.
MAGA, you have zero credibility in this kingdom, all right? And I'm being very kind. All right, I'm being very kind to you, but you have zero credibility. And you know what? Before I go on to this next topic, because this next topic is definitely an example of where we're going. I used to be a lot kinder to MAGA. I really did, Angela. Are you there, Angela? We used to be a lot kinder to MAGA, but we can't be kinder. We can't be kind to them because the gloves are off, right? The gloves are off.
Everyone knows he's in. And I wouldn't have said this 3 weeks ago.
I wouldn't have said it.
I was actually very kind to him. I was very kind to him.
But
no, we can't be kind anymore because the gloves are off.
Right.
The jar has been opened.
It's open. The gloves are off, MAGA, and the jar is open. All right. We know what you're up to, which is no good. We know what you stand for, which is evil. All right. We know what you tell, which is lies. All right. And the jig is up. And so now we got to come in with expert precision and shut you down. And that's what these lives are all about. So let's move on to our next topic, ladies and gentlemen. And this one right here. And I would love to hear a Trump supporter explain this. I really would. So Saudi Arabia extends oil production cuts, even though the United States gas prices hit a 9-month high.
Yeah, they're doing it.
You know, these folks are out here crying. You know, I have one of these things I read all the time, right? I have all of President Biden's accomplishments, right? And one of the accomplishments that I love to read, I have it here as number 5. Help bring gas prices down more than $1.60 from their summer peak, right, in 2022. So you know President Biden is trying to keep the gas prices down. But, you know, Donald Trump, what did he do in Saudi Arabia? You remember when he went to Saudi Arabia and he had his hands on the globe? Remember Jared Kushner got that $2.5 billion from Saudis and Qatar? And so word around town, ladies and gentlemen, and I believe it to be true 100% in my heart. These folks in Saudi Arabia are trying to help Donald Trump get reelected, all right? And get this, one way to do it is to make the American people pay at the pump. What a shame. Yeah, because they're in on it. I know. Right. They're in on it. So what they're doing is cutting the cost of production to jack up the price of the gas so that people in the United States can complain, oh, the gas prices are so high. Well, why are they high? Oh, because Donald Trump's buddy over there, MBS, right? And we know what he did. This guy's dangerous. They cut the production because they're trying their best to get Donald Trump to get a second term. And it's not going to work because the American people are wise and we know it. But this is what this is about. This is what I like to call the real election interference. Yes, the gloves are off, MAGA. We found another scandal you're a part of and organizing. So you're out here jacking up the gas prices to make President Biden look bad? Wow. Wow. What a shame, MAGA. What a shame. What a shame. What a shame. And it won't work. It really, really won't work because I know a lot of good people that have the ability to see right through this, all right? And listen, I know the Trump supporters are in here and they're mad at me right now because I'm showing all of this evidence, this information. Let me do this. Let me say this. If you don't like this level of truth that I'm bringing, all right, do us all a huge favor and just leave.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave. As far as
today, I'm not lying.
If you hate our country, if you're not happy here, you can leave. If you're not happy in the U.S., if you're complaining all the time, very simply, you can leave. You can leave right now.
Yeah.
Come back if you want. Don't come back. It's okay too. But if you're not happy, you can leave.
Yeah, if you're not happy in this country, this great country, MAGA, do us all a huge favor with your toxic evil selves. Get the heck out of this country and go on over there to China and drink some of that orange juice with mop water, right? Let's go over there and have some orange juice with mop water. Yeah. Okay? Because lies will not be tolerated in this kingdom. And if anybody in this kingdom is being disgusting, I saw what you wrote, Tiffany. I didn't see everything. But if anybody in here is being disgusting, yes, please mute or block those evil MAGA possessed folks, because see, I know these folks ain't real Christians. I know these folks ain't real Christians. You know, if anything, they're hypocrites. And MAGA, I do gotta say this. Let's take a break, MAGA. I want you all to understand this. Not only is Joe Biden your president, all right, but he's also Donald Trump's president, right? You Trump supporters, all right? I just want you all to know where we stand on a lot of things, all right? Now let's move on to our next topic, ladies and gentlemen. And this is what I want to make sure all you so-called Christians understand, all right? Churches can lose their tax-exempt status if they tell people how to vote. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we have evidence. Tennessee church loses tax exemption after their pastor says you can't be a Christian and vote for Democrats. What a shame. Demon. You're a demon. Ladies and gentlemen, you got to hear this. You got to hear this stuff. This is why I do what I do, because I can tell within a split second when that MAGA demon is in somebody. And this is a good example of the MAGA demon, ladies and gentlemen. You know how the Bible says, you know, they come to you as wolves in sheep clothing. This is what they say.
It's right now. If you vote Democrat, I don't even want you around this church. You get out. You get out, you demon. You get out, you baby butchering election thief. You cannot be a Christian and vote Democrat in this nation. I don't care how mad it makes you. You get pissed off as you want to. You cannot be a Christian and vote Democrat in this nation. They are God-denying demons that butcher babies and hate this nation. They hate this nation. Get mad all you want to. I don't care if you stay. I don't care if you throw tomatoes, praise God. I'm about to throw a microphone up at his house. CNN take my dirty socks. You cannot be a Democrat and a Christian. You cannot. Somebody say amen. Rest of you, get out. Get out. Get out in the name of Jesus. I ain't playing your stupid games. Bunch of devils. I'm sick of it.
See, ladies and gentlemen, let's stop right there. You know, this is why we don't tolerate MAGA in this live, because you know what this hypocrite sounds like to me? He sounds like a demon. Yeah. Now, you notice, if you listen to what he said, you know what he failed to do? He failed to provide any scripture to justify what he was saying. You know what he did? He was using and abusing the pulpit. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give this so-called pastor, who's really a wolf in sheep's clothing, let's just give him his daily dose of booze and shame. So, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you how this story goes, all right? This video cost this church their tax exemption status. Yes, in a move that surprised absolutely no one. All right, this controversial pastor of Global Vision Bible Church, all right, was investigated by the IRS after he made what some might consider slightly partisan comments during a recent sermon. All right, you heard what he said. All right, and this is the ruling, ladies and gentlemen. This is what the ruling is. All right. So can the church lose its tax exempt status by getting involved in politics? The answer is absolutely. All right. This is what this guy said. This pastor said he got a letter from the IRS asking him to explain, you know, his message and what it meant, and this is what he did. Rather than respond, he denounced the church tax exempt status and said he held the same views about Democrats. In a live stream he uploaded to Facebook, he said, guess what I did this week? I got an attorney. This is what he did. And I dissolved our stinking 501c3 status in this church because the government ain't going to tell me what I can and what I can't say. So IRS, we don't need your stupid tax exempt status. You can put it in a bag and burn it in front of your yard for all we care. I renounce 501c3 communism in church. Good. I'm glad he came to the realization on his own after the pressure was put on him that what he was doing wasn't helping poor people. What he was doing wasn't helping the widows and the fatherless. What he was doing was abusing the pulpit for political purposes. Greetings, Red Crown. And ladies and gentlemen, once you do that, you encroach upon some dangerous territory, all right? Just an FYI, according to the IRS tax guidelines for church and religious organizations, churches are expressly forbidden from activities that promote one candidate over the other. You hear that, Janae? So when you're in that church and your pastor is in there talking about President Biden and promoting Donald Trump, I want you to know, Janae, you're not in a church. That's more proof that most likely where you're at is in some sort of organized cult movement, right? Being honest, all right? So I just want to make sure I put that out there in case you were wondering, all right? Now, I'm well into the time where I'm supposed to open up the boxes. And by the way, good morning. Good morning, Shay. How are you doing? So I'm going to jump right to the end and then open up the boxes. Yes, I want to bring this to everyone's attention. From Sleepy Joe to Crooked Joe, Trump tries to redraw his portrait of President Joe Biden, right? All right. And this is just a friendly reminder, Trump supporters. And I got to say this because I was talking to my good friend Snuggles, right? You know, him and I, we go back and forth. You know, I'll say this. He's a decent person, you know, outside of politics. But when it comes to politics, he's a very nasty person. I mean, politically, Snuggles is wrong 110% of the time, all right? And so the question I keep posing to these folks is this. explain to Zeus, if you can, okay, MAGA, I want you to use all of your brain power. Explain to Zeus, how did Sleepy Joe, this is the first moniker Donald Trump gave President Biden back, you know, when they were running in 2020. How did Sleepy Joe run a campaign in his basement, right? You said he was in his basement. His rallies, they were just the smallest of rallies, right? I mean, you wouldn't even see anyone at a Biden rally. How did this guy beat President Trump? You know, President Trump had the power of the Oval Office, and somehow he lost to Sleepy Joe. I'm scratching my head, and I'm like, how on earth did this happen? MAGA, please explain how this happened. Because it happened, right? He won, right? And so I want to know when he went from Sleepy Joe, in your world, to Crooked Joe. Can he be both? Because this is what's going to decide the 2024 election, MAGA, all right? All right. Can President Biden be both sleepy and, I would argue, crooked at the same time? Can he be sleepy and crooked at the same time, MAGA? Because, you know, when it comes to this Crooked Joe Biden stuff, every accusation that we've heard, I mean, we've heard about corruption, right? I mean, we've heard about bank accounts in China. So there's 24 hours in a day, MAGA. Let's just do the math. Out of those 24 hours, how many of those hours is President Biden asleep? All right, MAGA, there's 24 hours in a day. How many of those hours is President Biden asleep? I mean, if you got a name like Sleepy Joe, I would definitely say he sleeps more than 8 hours, right? 18? All right, 22. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Let's do the math. All right, so he sleeps 22, 14? Is that a good number, MAGA? 15, all right, so if there's, let's just say that means there's 9 hours left. 17, oh crap, man. You think he's sleeping that much? Oh my gosh. all right. So that gives us about 12 hours, nine, okay. So let's say he sleep 15 hours. That gives us 9 hours. In those 9 hours, how many of those hours does he spend doing his job as president? I'm asking. I mean, because where we're ultimately headed is, I want to know. He doesn't do anything. Oh, they said zero. Two, okay, two. Seven, okay, seven, right. You know, he has to do some work, right? I mean, okay, so you got to eat, you know, I mean, look at what an average human has to do. You got to eat, you got to work, you got to do some things to take care of your health. Because don't you say he's golfs a lot? Don't you say Biden's on vacation quite a bit as well? So ultimately, my question is, out of those 24 hours, how many of those hours a day can he use to be Crooked Joe, MAGA? How many of those hours can he use to be crooked? I'm looking out there. Oh, zero. Okay, yeah, that sounds about right. How many hours is Biden using to be Crooked Joe Biden every day? I'm asking. No, there's not enough for that. Nope, six doesn't work. There's only 24 hours in a day. Come on, do your math. All right. How many hours per day is he being crooked, MAGA? If he sleep most of the day, all right, he's on vacation, he's eating, he's sniffing, right? You know, they say he sniffs kids and stuff like that. You know, I talked to my friend Janae. This is all he does is sniff, okay? Well, if he's doing all this, how much time is he spending per day being crooked, all right? And then I want you to, oh, you know, go to the next level with this. To run a crime enterprise, how many hours a day do you think it takes to actually be successful at running a criminal enterprise, all right? I mean, think about this, MAGA. Because this is what I'm going to make sure you understand. According to my sources this weekend, all right, I got some bad news for you, Trump supporters. I really do. President Biden, according to my sources, he's back in his basement again.
getting ready to launch his campaign against Donald Trump. And I heard this one's going to be more vicious than the first one. All right. So guess what? If you thought Trump got beat last time was wild, wait until you see what Biden comes out of the basement with this time. All right. It's over, MAGA. It's over because we played this game with you long enough. Your math isn't adding up. He can't beat both Sleepy Joe and Crooked Joe at the same time. There's just not enough hours in the day. All right. And this is what you're dealing with right now. You can't believe that President Biden is as squeaky clean as he really is. All right. Your math isn't adding up, and it, all the resources you're putting in to trying to accuse him of doing something he didn't do, you're leaving your rear ends wide open, all right? They're wide open because you don't even see the attack that's about to come because your head's so focused on the lie. All right, MAGA, and I'm giving you some free insight. Please take my advice and get it together on your side, or this next election in 2024, you're going to get beat so bad. You really are. And this time we got you. We're going to be waiting for you at the Capitol on January 6th. All right. There's going to be extra traps set to catch MAGA. All right. We're going to have your leader in jail. All right. And perhaps if he doesn't get his soul right, we will definitely have him going to hell. All right, so listen up, Trump supporters. Before I open up, you know, I got to open up these boxes, all right? Because it's time to hear from those of you who are brave enough to get in the box and tell the truth. But I just want to make sure MAGA understands this. President Biden is not corrupt or crooked. Donald Trump is. And we have proof, all right? President Biden, while you might think he's Sleepy Joe, the proof of the matter is he ran such a great campaign during the 2020 election that he ended up taking the Oval Office from Donald John Trump, all right? And at the end of the day, we are also witnessing Donald Trump and his supporters being prosecuted because of what they tried to do to prevent President Biden from being president, right? You know, they tried to steal the 2020 election. We are witnessing, as far as I am concerned, one of the best rescue efforts of a president in our lifetime. Because had President Biden not had the courage to stand up to Donald Trump, okay, and take that office from him, we all know this country would be going down in degradation. Don't we, ladies and gentlemen? Don't we know it would be going down in degradation? So this Labor Day, ladies and gentlemen, I want you all to, you know, enjoy yourselves, but also I want you all to, you know, count your lucky stars and thank the Lord that we have President Biden in the White House this Labor Day and not Donald John Trump. Donald John Trump, who we all know is the real crooked one out there, all right? So let's give Biden a round of applause. All right, let's open up these boxes and hear from those of you who are brave enough to get in the box and tell the truth, all right? It's like my grandmother says, tell the truth and shame the devil. And no, I don't want to argue with Trump supporters today. The only thing I want to hear from a Trump supporter today is, I'm sorry. Do we have any Trump supporters? Do we have any Trump supporters out there that would like to apologize to the United States of America this morning? By show of hands, any Trump supporters want to apologize to the United States of America, all right? Because you know you owe this country an apology for what you did. Oh, you don't, Chris, cut it out. Seriously, Chris, you know, you don't got to use profanity in here. I thought you were a Christian. Miller, you don't want to apologize? Okay, well, let me tell you why you should apologize. And I've been... You should apologize for what you've done to this country. You drug this nation through hell because you chose to listen to Donald Trump and his lies. This is why you owe America an apology. You got all of this taxpayer money being spent to investigate what? Hunter Biden? Did Hunter Biden run for office? No. I'm not, I would apologize if I lied or got something wrong. You know me, I'm the most humble person on social media. But you Trump supporters, you lack humility. You lack honesty. You lack integrity. And all you are is full of evil. Evil. And so that's why I don't talk to you Trump supporters, because you know what I say? You know what it's like talking to a Trump supporter, ladies and gentlemen? You know the conversation's not going anywhere. Most of the stuff they claim is based on lies and misinformation. Arguing with a Trump supporter, ladies and gentlemen, you know what it reminds me of? You ever had one of those cars that, you know, you could hear the engine and you could just tell this car isn't going to go anywhere? That's what it's like talking to a Trump supporter, all right? It sounds a little something like this.
Please turn that thing off.
That engine sounds terrible. That's the mind of a Trump supporter, though. Got a lot of backfiring, right? Something's wrong with your fuel injectors. Something, your timing is off. When was the last time you took it to a mechanic and let them look at that thing? I'm talking about your minds, MAGA. All right? You're out here using profanity, every other word, and then you wear it. They got these chains around their neck with gold crosses on them. They call themselves Christians. They got their Bibles. You know, these Bibles, they try to make them look like they're used, right? But I know they buy those Bibles from the Salvation Army, all right? Because they don't read those things, all right? They're hypocrites. They got fake pastors in front of these churches taking advantage of the United States tax code, all because they're so money hungry, all right? Fascists. Yeah, MAGA, you owe the United States of America an apology. You should be doing community service every single weekend until the good Lord calls you home. I don't care how much Sound of Freedom you watch. I really don't. I don't care that you give $20 to your local church. I don't care. Look at the works that you're putting out. Look at the evil you do. Look at what you do on social media. You call yourselves Christians and you get out here and you lie. You threaten people. All right. Yeah. You engage in all kinds of abuse. Good morning, Yazzie. Nice to see you. You engage in all kinds of abusive conduct. All right. And by the way, anybody that engages in abusive conduct, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. You need to repent too. I don't care if you're Democrat or Republican. As far as I'm concerned, you're just as guilty as MAGA. All right? All right. So let's open up these boxes, ladies and gentlemen, and get to doing the work that this country needs us to do. Getting rid of that MAGA demon so that this country can begin healing. All right? And I mean that with my whole chest. MAGA, you have no credibility in this kingdom. You've got nothing correct. Nothing. You lied about the 2020 election. You lied about January 6th. You lied and said that Donald Trump wouldn't get indicted. And you're lying right now talking about zero convictions. Donald Trump, ladies and gentlemen, will be convicted and Donald Trump will go to jail. Mark my words. And I don't care if it's President Biden's corrupt DOJ that does it. As far as I'm concerned, I'm going to add Biden's DOJ as a list of accomplishments to all the other things Biden has done. As a matter of fact, I've already done it. Biden has empowered Merrick Garland to appoint special counsel Jack Smith to make sure Jack Smith uses every tool the federal government has available to prosecute the seditionist, treasonous, former thug of a president, Donald John Trump, and his minions. I don't care if Alvin Bragg sent his resume to President Joe Biden, and Joe Biden says, listen, you can't work in the DOJ, but I can get you in at New York. I don't care if Fannie Willis submitted her resume to Kamala Harris and said, listen,
I need a job with the administration. And Kamala Harris said, listen, maybe working directly in the White House isn't fine, but if you get on out there to Atlanta, we're going to have a big fish and a big opportunity for it. I don't care. Use whatever tool the federal government has to make sure Donald Trump and his nasty, evil supporters do not ever take that Confederate flag in the United States Capitol ever again. Seditionist, treasonous thugs. All right, I'm getting angry, and it's supposed to be Labor Day, and I'm getting angry at MAGA, and I shouldn't be. I should be celebrating, but I'm getting upset with MAGA because every time I think about what they did on January 6th, it makes me angry. Good morning, Nutty Professor. How are you doing?
Good morning. Happy Labor Day. So,
happy Labor Day.
You know, we keep talking about accountability, right?
Absolutely.
So we have to be accountable, and we have to call out wrong when it's wrong. And so I'm going to call out wrong on our side. MAGA was absolutely right, Zeus.
Talk to him.
Joe Biden, he has committed some atrocities. And I do have proof of this.
Okay, let's get into it.
He is crooked.
Okay.
And he is sleepy.
Okay.
So here's my proof. This man, since he's been in the White House, has passed the Inflation Reduction Act.
Mm.
He passed the Burn Pit Act to help the veterans suffering from the burn pits.
Mm.
He's gotten our inflation rate down to 3%, which most economists say that's typically where you want it to be. All the nations in the world, economies in the world, the United States has the lowest inflation.
This is evil, man.
He opened up our reserves to kind of put more fuel out there to help bring down the gas prices, because we know he controls the gas prices.
Right.
So just like he controls inflation, so he must be the president of the world, because the last time I checked, the entire world was having a global inflation,
right?
Because we had a global pandemic.
Right.
Let's see what else. He put more than 500 million shots in arms to help with the COVID-19 to save some lives. Right.
Yeah. Evil.
Yeah. So he's pumped money into even the red states that work against him and call him sleepy, do this, that, and the other. He pumped money into their economy by the infrastructure bill.
Wow. That's evil.
Yeah, that's evil. So we know that, you know, he was down in Florida, you know, with the hurricanes, and DeSantis wouldn't even meet with him because he didn't want to be embarrassed on a national stage anymore by giving this man credit for his response to Hurricane Idalia, but it was actually their senator, who is ultra-conservative Rick Scott, came out and gave the president the credit that he deserves to his response to Hurricane Idalia. But yet, this man is evil. So where did I lie, MAGA? Where did I lie?
Yeah, where did Nutty lie? No lies detected.
Where did I lie? And this man is constantly putting money into states that absolutely hate him. But there's one thing that the former president said, and I'm talking about the real former president, Barack Hussein Obama. President Obama, in his victory speech, said that there is not a red state or a blue state. This is the United States. And Joe Biden has held to that every single day. Every single day that he's been in office, he has held to that. Because even though Florida is ultra-conservative red, they got a governor from hell. What did he do? He said he looked beyond their politics and said, I don't care if these people did not vote for me. They are Americans. They need the help of the federal government. But isn't it funny how they want to complain about the federal government, but when the disaster happens, they want the federal government. Make up your minds.
Right.
Make up your minds. And this is going out to shout out to Texas. Texas passed a bill that really looks at an option to seceding from the United States of America. Please go.
Right.
Please go. There will not be a fight if y'all want to leave the United States. But I will promise you this. You all will come running back within the first year.
Like
because
Elon
as soon as a natural disaster happens, you're going to want some money. And who do you have to turn to but your Texans? You know, everything's bigger in Texas, right?
Yeah.
So with that, I'll say this. Have a great Labor Day. And since y'all got a free day off work, why don't y'all, well, yeah, wait, they accuse us of not working. But right. since y'all have a day off work, why don't y'all just sit in your homes, don't barbecue, don't anything. Just sit and reflect on truly the things that Joe Biden has accomplished for the American people and not just red states. Be blessed.
Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to Brother Nutty.
Dark Nutty. I saw one comment. They said, is Nutty reading a script? No. No, Nutty's not reading a script. And none of the panelists that come up here, we don't got to read this. When the truth is in you, it comes out naturally. But you wouldn't know that, you Trump supporters, because there's no truth in you. The only thing you got is a bunch of lies and misinformation, probably from listening to Snuggles Live. All right. Welcome and good morning, the beautiful April. How are you doing?
Good morning. And I'm a little bit upset with you, Zeus. You said you were getting angry. This is time to rejoice. Oh. Biden is doing extremely well.
Hey, you're right.
Why are you saying we are winning, man? We're winning on all fronts.
Hallelujah. You're right, April. You're right.
Yeah,
but I get so upset about those January Sixers. Don't that make you angry?
Yeah, that makes us angry, but they're being held accountable. I mean, they're sitting in jail. hey, you do the
You're
crime,
right.
you do the time. So yes. I want to address the the churches, and I think it wasn't it Ken Locke you were playing the recording? Yes.
Yes. Yes.
So we have it. This, and you know I'm not a believer, and I'm you know, but I got a few scriptures for people to read that you know, and church and voting and all this is what God told you to do.
Right.
So let's talk about 2 Corinthians 3 and 4. Or as Trump would say it, Corinthians 2. So in that it says the most important reason why we should not be involved in political activism is due to our mission. We have been called to reach the world of the good news and not politics of salvation in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So don't stop me. You can't play two in one hand. And when you're supporting someone that's had billions and billions of dollars and does corrupted things, Tucker, be quiet, man. So, it's my dog.
Uh-oh, Tucker got something to say.
I'm going to have to walk and talk to let him out. But, Trump having all his money and all these, everybody, Christians, what, no, I said it wrong, fake Christians, right. Hypocrites, that says that. I also have a scripture for that. So this is how... You know, you do your research. You're not a follower, but, you know, you've got to be informed of what people's talking about. So let's bring up Matthew 6:24.
Uh-oh.
No one can serve two masters, for he will hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and money.
You can't.
So, all you hypocrites out there saying, complaining about the gas prices, complaining about 401ks, all this other stuff.
Ooh.
Yeah, preach somewhere else.
Ooh.
Preach somewhere else.
What did you have this morning?
Oh, I had 20,000 bowls of Frosted Flakes.
Hallelujah! Oh my God!
But so all you fake Christians out there, that support Trump and the MAGA movement, open your Bible once in a while. I'm not a believer and do it. So.
Open their Bibles? You know they haven't opened their Bibles. They haven't cracked the Bible open, and they never have. I can't say even when they did.
Yeah, I
tell them, April.
I just don't understand these people. They want to preach to preach, but they don't know one word of the Bible.
Not
like
one.
Like Trump. They asked him, was the Old or New Testament? I liked them both. He couldn't tell what he liked.
Wow.
Could you name a Bible verse? Name one Bible verse, but these people are saying, oh, God appointed him. He does the God's work. You can't love money and God at the same time.
You
can't do it. They're God told liars. You that.
Yeah. And it's sad that you have to do their homework for them, April. It's sad.
Yeah. And when he tells you to stay out of politics, Christians, stay out of politics. That is not your job. Your job is to spread the news of Jesus.
Amen.
Your job is not to stand up and promote
they're promoting a sinner.
Yeah, a sinner, an orange sinner. But,
orange sinner. Tell them, people.
I just wanted to come up with that because, you know, if people would just open their Bible.
Mm.
So that's all it takes. Then you would say, hey, maybe I shouldn't follow this man and support him of all the stuff he's done wrong.
Yeah.
So I heard my bell, and everybody have a great Labor Day. And I'm going to cook some burgers today and enjoy the sunshine. And enjoy
the weather today. How the weather out there?
That's it. Have a great one, Zeus, and happy Labor Day.
Same to you, April. Same to you. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to the beautiful April. No lies detected. All right, she came in here and she called out these so-called Christians. And then she says, I'm going to go ahead and make myself some burgers for Labor Day. Oh, my God. Living the dream, April. Living the dream. All right. Good morning, Tiffany. How are you doing?
Good morning, Zeus. Zeusy. Juicy Zeusy.
Well, listen, I am what they say I am, all right? I am.
Hey, listen, if you want to use that for some merch, I will allow you to take it.
Zeusy Juicy?
Well, Juicy Zeusy with the truthy.
Oh, Juicy Zeusy with the truthy. I might. Maybe I'll make that on some. I'll get some sweatpants and, you know, put that right around the waist.
Not the sweat. Listen. Calm down. Don't be getting the ladies in a tizzy in here, Zeus. Not the sweatpants so early.
Yeah. Let me keep it clean. I'm so sorry. I gotta keep it clean.
No, but on a serious note, I do want to just say thank you because I had just woken up and this person in the comments was being incredibly disgusting. And this is where we have to take MAGA very seriously because I'm not sure if I can say this, but I'm not a lie, but I think I can. But he was like promoting stealthing, if you know what that is.
I don't know what the heck that is.
Okay, I would say Google it. It's a form of essay. It's called stealthing. Oh, it's like now just being talked about. It's also like an unwanted advance, assuming that he would be able to sleep with me or engage in something with me. And
wow,
you know, he
losers.
Yeah, losers. I mean, this is why, like, any of these white men that look like that, I look at with a side eye all the time because they look the same. They all
what do they look like?
They kind of look okay. So,
at do they have the face scrunched up?
Yeah. So it could be like it usually involves some kind of flag, right? Do you guys see these guys out here, white men, MAGAs that wear these like different versions of flags, the thin blue line, all those things on their hats, on their cars. It's very suspect. It's giving January 6th. It's giving where were you? Okay. As much as you hate to be, you don't want to think that all of them stand for that, but it's very indicative at this point, like of what I think of who they are.
Wow. 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 They're January 6ers, huh?
Right.
And they're, you know, criminals in a way, but in a nasty way.
Exactly. And I think Nutty said it too, like And I had made a point in one of my videos that I made, like, listen, during the pandemic, we had a lot of time to sit down and like reflect and do better as humanity, right? Like, I went back to school, like a lot of people like really had a chance to reflect. So let me make this sense, make this make sense, MAGA. So y'all like white people, like, you know, men like MAGA, y'all got worse. Y'all regressed literally during that time. You got worse during that time. Like, you could have used that as an opportunity to do better and you got worse. And you were heavily influenced by Trump's lies, et cetera, et cetera. Like, why didn't you use that? Why didn't you use that time to do something better?
Don't get in your feelings now. She's telling the truth. I haven't heard one single lie. You could have been really opening your Bible and reading it. You could have been volunteering out here in the community. But whatever you did, correct me if I'm lying, but whatever they did, it resulted in them showing up to the Capitol on January 6th.
Right. We talk about this a lot, but like the power of influence that this MAGA demon has over them.
Oh my God, it does.
It's so sad. It's so sad. And you're right. They do need to apologize to the real people of this country who actually stand for democracy. Like, earlier in the comments, I said something about Biden math.
math
guys. It's my 8-year-old can, and like, I remember I asked her in 2020. I was like, honey, like, when an election happens, the person who gets the most votes is the one who, and she's like, probably wins, mom, right? I mean, she was what, 5 back then? Like,
she gets it.
She got it at 5. MAGA, it's just simple math. Biden won by a large number of votes. So,
large numbers.
And somebody just said in the comments, like, oh, you've seen these people who are like, oh, Biden isn't really president. Well, Zeus, these people really need to, like, be maybe in an asylum.
They do. And listen, we're trying to get 7 Trump supporters to take us up on our offer and go to Russia, but they won't do it.
Exactly. And I like to hear your takes on, like, what do you think about when these MAGA demons always threaten a civil war?
Oh, when they tell me that there's a civil war brewing, and I told you, these Trump supporters are out of shape, all right? They can barely make it to McDonald's. These Trump supporters, they can barely make it to McDonald's. They weigh 300-400 pounds. They go on, you know, Trump lied about his weight. What did he say? He weighed 215, 6'3". Oh, well, okay. You're an athlete? Yeah, so huh?
I was just going to say, and look how decrepit and deplorable and sad they looked in their wannabe tactical gear on January 6th. Guys, that was one day y'all could barely get it together. Let's really be honest. Come on.
Right. And they turn on each other. I mean, every time a Trump supporter, you catch them, they all tell on each other. It wasn't me, it was him. So I'm like, there's no organization.
No.
This would be a terrible group of troops to lead.
Exactly.
You would fumble the simplest play. You would literally... I mean, they're so silly.
I mean, I know my time is up. They couldn't, let me just leave that there. They could not organize a children's play, let's be honest, let alone some kind of war insurgents. Let's really be honest.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Thank you, Zeus. Everybody, don't do too much labor on Labor Day, okay? And Zeus, don't do too much laboring for these MAGAs out here.
I won't. I will enjoy my freedom out here. All right. And thank you so much,
Tiffany. Thank you for having me. Bye, guys.
Bye-bye. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to the beautiful Tiffany. You might have a few out there that are actually training, but it's not enough to actually win, right? So 99% of the Trump supporters, as far as I'm concerned, the only civil war they're concerned about is the one with the menu at McDonald's, all right? I mean, listen, the price of those things is costing them a lot of money, and that's the real war. Oh, yeah. Ah, they're charging me so much for this number one when I supersize it with a Coke, all right? That's the civil war they're talking about, because I know none of them have the discipline, the courage, the mental fortitude that it takes to lace those boots up, get into those fatigues, all right, take all the money out of their bank accounts, send it to Donald Trump, and put their boots on the ground and wait for their leader to show up in full regalia and lead them north, all right? Right? You know, because Trump would have to actually put his boots on the ground out there, whatever state, let's start with Florida. All of you would have to assemble in Florida by the thousands. Imagine all of you on your cell phones
taking orders from Donald Trump on Twitter, because that's how this would work. And you would all, I can't even go there. Oh my God. I can't even go there. Oh my God. Oh, it is shame. It is. It is shame. These Trump supporters, they know they can't follow orders. They barely can, you know, wake up on time. All right. Let's move on to our next guest. All right. Good morning, Brother Red Cloud. Can you imagine Angela? Right. I can't imagine these folks doing that. Good morning, Red Crown. How are you doing? Happy Labor Day.
Good morning, Zeus. How are you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing great. I'm just enjoying the time.
Yeah. Can you put me in the big box for a second? A little bit?
You got it. Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
hold
sir.
On. Hold on. Let me get
all right.
Let me get live here. Hold on.
All right. You are officially in the big box. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing good. I just wanted to show something. I made a statement the other day about January 6th that they even had t-shirts or sweatshirts printed up, you know, for the event. And anyway, I found the reference. Somebody wanted to know the reference.
Okay.
And it was through Money Magazine. It was January 12th, 2021. It says, spelled out right there in the sweatshirts, MAGA, Civil War, January 6, 2021.
Oh.
The three men wore these commemorative merchandise with Trump hats and self-satisfied grins.
Oh.
Anyway, and I got a picture of it I'm going to show you here. Hold on a second.
Show us this traitorous outfit.
Yes. Doing it now. Hold on one second. Let me know what you can see.
Okay. I'm looking. So I'm glad you're doing this so that I can
hold
know
it, hold
what,
it, hold it, hold it.
What to look for. Now I see you. Did you want us to see you?
I wanted to see the other one. Hold on a second.
Show us what these folks were wearing. Uh-oh. A whole three guys. Yeah, they think they're going to do something, but, you know, this is what we do.
Yep.
Uh-oh.
So, yes. Says MAGA, Civil War, January 6, 2021.
Wait a second. That's a real picture.
That's a real picture.
Is that the FBI? Is that, like, yeah, was that BLM or Antifa? How do you know?
Oh, I don't know. They don't have their business cards showing.
So look at this, ladies and gentlemen. We have, once again, Trump supporters in Trump gear committing crimes in broad daylight, or as the young folks like to say, in 8K. What a shame!
So, anyway, I thought that you might find that interesting.
Wow. I'm not surprised at this point. You know, it's something that, you know, you wish our friends on the right would actually talk about more. Why do you think they never bring this up, Red?
Because it shows they're guilty.
It shows that they are guilty, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. What an interesting.
I mean, that's just about as truthful as you can get. You know?
What a shame.
And, so, like I said, I'm so excited for October 23rd to get here.
Any special plans that you are going to do while we watch that?
Actually, I had some high-grade popcorn, but I think I'm going to throw that away, and I'm going to get some super high-grade popcorn since these things will be televised and streamed. So I just plan to have a feast, you know, with extra butter.
Yeah. You know? Yeah. No, you're doing the right thing, because I'm glad they're going to televise, because we won't have to rely on Donald Trump's and his attorney's version of events any longer, right?
Exactly. Now, the only thing, though, that will aggravate me is once they do something, you know, and then they take a break, and then the commentators come on, I hate them telling me what I heard.
Oh, yeah.
You understand?
They're going to try to fill your head with their version of events.
Yeah, I was sitting here. I heard what they said. You know, there we go. My eggs are done. So
your eggs are done. That's so hilarious. That's a good way to put it. All right. You already ate breakfast, I take it. Or you're about to.
Well, I've had my second cup of coffee, so.
Okay. Well, anyway, keep up the great work, my friend. All right. And as always, it's a pleasure checking in with you bright and early.
I appreciate you, sir.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to Brother Red.
Bye, guys.
Lies detected. All right. You see, ladies and gentlemen, you know, what's very important that we do is we tell the truth and shame the devil. You Trump supporters, y'all ought to be ashamed of yourselves. You commit crimes and tell on yourself, and then you get upset when you get arrested. I don't get it. You see these folks getting prosecuted up there in D.C., you know, what was his name? Mr. Biggs, right? You know, in the Proud Boys. He's crying because he got 17 years. And I say to myself, why are you crying? All of this could have been prevented if you would have believed the people around you that were telling you you were believing lies. We've been on TikTok ad nauseum telling MAGA to stop believing Donald Trump. And do they listen? No. But yet, they cry when it's time to do the due time. It's the most bizarre thing I've ever seen. And you know what, MAGA? You deserve to get your daily dose of booze and shame. Get out of here. If you don't repent, MAGA, listen to what I'm telling you, and I'm going to keep saying this. Jail is definitely guaranteed if you continue to support Donald Trump, period. It's not even optional. It's required. Any Trump supporter, listen to what I'm telling you. You are required to go to jail for Donald Trump. You're also required to send him your money. You really are. And if you're not doing those things, then you're really not a Donald Trump supporter. You're a fake Trump supporter, which I would argue is even worse. Okay? You don't even belong. But to the real Trump supporters, jail is required, all right? And if you do not get your soul right, all right, hell is also going to be required. And like my good friend April said, okay, you cannot serve God and money. And it's quite clear to me that if you are a Trump supporter, you're not serving God. You're serving money and Donald Trump at best. All right? So let's move on and open up these boxes and hear from more people. Good morning, Sister Patricia! Yeah, right. Send your money to Donald Trump.
Good morning, Zeus. How are you?
I'm all right. How are you?
I'm good. What's the lady name that was before Red?
Tiffany.
Okay, for the man that tried to say that to Tiffany in the comments, I'm pretty sure you're one of those that have to sit down and use the bathroom and wear Band-Aids for underwear. Leave that lady alone. Now, check this out, Zeus. April gonna keep on researching those scriptures and tripping to salvation, and I'm gonna love it when that day comes. But let's talk about Greg Lark.
Okay,
that's the same man that cheated on his wife with the secretary of his church and is now married to that lady.
Oh!
He shouldn't be standing up saying nothing but, Lord, forgive me. He be doing all that hollering and acting a nut in that church. And when he's unalived, you know, when it's his time to go, he gonna be one of the ones the Lord said, go on about your business because I ain't never knew you. You took your time instead of spreading the good news of me. You went on a rampage about Donald Trump. You can go on where you were. You gone on to the place that enlarged itself for you, which is hell. Because that's where he at, hell bound.
Hell bound. I've heard of spell bound. But hell bound is a new one. Check this out.
Donald Trump calling anybody crooked is like a skunk saying you stink. it's like Don Jr. speaking at a drug rehab.
Oh, Lord.
It's like Eric Trump doing a commercial for braces.
Oh, Lord.
It's like Melania Trump speaking at a women's conference saying keep your clothes on.
Oh, Lord.
It's hypocritical. Donald Trump, be quiet, please. I've never seen a man who can be sleeping and wide awake at the same time. You got a mob meeting at 12, you sleep at 12:01. You got a mob meeting at 12:02, you sleep at 12:03. You got a mob meeting at 12:04, you sleep at 12:05. I know Joe Biden eyelids are tired. Time they shut, they open right back up.
Yeah.
Time they shut, they open right back up. He is the sleepiest, wokest man I've ever seen in all my life, Susan.
Right, right.
Make it make sense.
I can't. I don't know how the MAGA demon works.
It ain't making sense to nobody but MAGA. Because they the only one pushing it like a lawnmower on a hot summer's day with hedges and grass growing up 15 inches. They pushing it hard, Zeus. And I'm sick of it. Leave that man alone. That man ain't bothering y'all. Just like Ron DeSantis didn't want to walk with the man. You know why he really didn't want to walk with him, Zeus?
Why?
Because them white high-heel Prince boots he ordered didn't come in time. And he knew if he stood next to Joe Biden, he'll come to his waist. And he didn't want to be embarrassed.
Oh, Lord!
That's all that was about, Zeus.
He sounds like he's very vain.
Zeus.
Talk to him.
The man is not vain. The man is ashamed. He too short. He too short. He couldn't stand up.
You ain't talking about the rapper, huh?
Listen, he couldn't stand up against Joe Biden if they put 15 boxes behind that podium.
Keep going.
Now, that's all I had to say. That was my rant for today.
Oh.
I'm finna go feed my grandbaby some breakfast.
Okay.
And I want y'all to have an awesome Labor Day, everybody. Even the Trumpers.
You want them to have an awesome Labor Day.
I want them to have an awesome day as well, because we got to show them some love. We got to show them what real love is, because the fake love is taking over their minds.
Yeah. What do you think these Trump supporters, you know, Tiffany brought up something, you know, during the pandemic, a lot of them got radicalized. What do you think about that?
They were at home looking at Trump's picture, rubbing it. Thinking of ways to put it on their body and trucks and houses. They were magnified. So all they did was just look at the picture and got more magnified. And
magnified
to the 100th power. And they don't know how to get unmagnified.
Ah! You're right. I'm going to have to use that. They got magnified.
Magnified. Yeah.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Where you come up with this stuff at?
Magnified and magnetized. Goodbye, Zeus.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to the beautiful Takesha. Magnified. Yeah. That's what that MAGA demon does, all right? Yeah, it does. It's a good word. It's a really good word. It makes sense, too. I've never seen grown men love another man like these Trump supporters, love Donald Trump, and then turn around and say, but I'm not a member of the LGBTQI+ community. I'm straight. You know, you go in there and you talk to Snuggles, I'm a straight man. But he's just loving Donald Trump. Every time I see him, he's in there, he has a picture of Trump up in the background, and he got these lips. He's kissing on this photo with Donald Trump, and he's kissing on all the other Trump. And I'm like, dude, make this make sense. If you want to be in the community, just go. But you're lying to me and everyone else that you don't love Donald Trump when we see you putting pictures up and kissing him. And by the way, did you brush your teeth? I mean, seriously, right?
You Trump, and they paint their trucks. They got Trump underwear. I seen these guys. I mean, listen, you go into these locker rooms sometimes.
I went into the locker room one time. Grown man, out of shape, belly hanging out. You know, he had his belly hanging over him. And I'm like, put that away, please, you know, because I got to focus on just kind of doing what I got to do. And then I looked and I glanced. He had Trump underwear with pictures of Donald Trump on him. Ladies and gentlemen, these Trump men are disgusting. What a shame. Yeah. And then, you know, you like, hey, don't you think you're a little too old for that? And then he had the audacity to get upset with Zeus. And I'm like, listen, I don't know about you, but you're a little too old to be putting another grown man on your crotch area like that. Cut it out. These Trump supporters know I would never do such a thing, and yet they do it, and they try to act like they are somehow doing something great. It's the most bizarre thing. Good morning, Dionysius. Welcome. How are you doing this morning, brother? Dionysius, are you there? Going once. Going twice. Sold. All right. I guess, you know, I hear the birds chirping. I hear something in the background. Dionysius, come on. All right. Let's bring up our next guest. The beautiful Annette. Hello. How are you? I'm doing all
right. I'm good.
I'm doing all right.
Excellent.
You're looking mighty lovely today. What did you have for breakfast?
Thank you.
Did you have coffee?
I did have coffee.
I made
fried green plantains. I made cheese omelet for my daughter. I made fried green plantain, fried eggs, halloumi, and ham for my son.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I can nibble on everybody's food because I'm the cook.
Okay. I guess I need to borrow some of your recipes because, you know, it seems to be doing quite well. All right. Well, what do you have for us this morning, Annette?
MAGA is the battered wife of the political world.
Oh.
They keep going back to their abuser.
They do.
To the point that you guys made about, you know, at COVID, this thing got worse. Because these people were separated from normal society. Where there are rules about your behavior and decorum. And there was absolutely none of that. They allowed all of the extremism. Again, social media, outstanding tool. We have the knowledge of the universe at our fingertips. Right.
No
but it also brings all the crazy together.
Yeah, no lies.
And I'm mad. Like, what the hell? Didn't he promise to go away? Like, if I lose, you're never going to see me again.
He did. I remember that.
Why are you here? Boy, bye. Oh, never mind. You got to show up for court. So, yeah, please make yourself present when necessary.
Yes, show up for court.
Oh, and by the way, for everybody that is trading in their public assistance to buy NFTs to support a billionaire's bail and legal fees,
wait a second. They're
please try to critically think a little tiny bit.
They're trading in their what?
Oh, well, these are people that don't have the means to support themselves. A lot of them are on government assistance.
Mom. Wow.
It's insane.
And they're willing to give up government assistance for these Trump NFTs?
Yes. Because that's according to their preacher, that's their saving grace. That's their way into heaven. Forget Jesus. Forget all those Christian teachings you got before. This guy right here, the three-time adulterer. That has cheated on every single one of his wives. The abuser that we saw on Oprah when he was on there with Don Jr. and the fear in that boy's eyes. Do you guys remember that interview?
No.
Where it's like, what would you say about your dad? Yeah, he is shook. It's an Oprah interview from the 90s, and he is absolutely petrified. And he's like, hey, look, he's got, you know, his daughter that he's cut and had encouraged her to slice and dice herself up so much she can't breathe out her nose. Wow. You got Gumby, the paste eater, and you got Cokie McSniffles. I mean,
No lies detected. So you don't think he's doing a good job as a parent raising his children?
Wow. I don't think he did a good job, and I think Melania is the smartest of all his wives and took that baby away from him.
Mm. Yeah, I agree.
She's the only one that's truly protecting her kid. I applaud her for that.
Yeah. You know, I heard he got in trouble with Melania because she told him Barron was off limits, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then Trump put a picture up of Barron Trump supposedly debating Biden. You saw that photo one time?
I did not.
Oh, yeah. You know, they were basically insinuating that, you know, since Trump can't go to the debates because he'll be, you know, fighting his court cases, he'll send Barron Trump. All right. And he put it up on his Truth Social
platform.
Of
and
course
I heard he did. Melania lost it on him.
Oh, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Good for her.
Yeah. She said those kid, our child is off limits, you creep.
Good.
You monster.
As she should.
Yeah.
She needs to protect that baby. And as far as his appearances, like, everybody buy stock, it depends. The accidents will become more frequent. They'll become more extreme.
Oh, wow.
People that are actual MAGA supporters, I feel sorry for you that you haven't seen that you've been duped yet. I really hope that you see the truth of what's actually going on.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I really do wish you well, because at the end of the day, you are my fellow American brothers and sisters. Mm. Even if we don't agree,
right,
we all want a good life for our families and we all want the best path forward. But if you think Donald Trump is 215 pounds, get help.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir, for having me up.
You're welcome, Annette. No problem. And as always, thank you for having the courage to get in the box and tell the truth. All right.
Now my pleasure.
You have a great rest of your day. Happy Labor Day to you and your family.
Happy Labor Day.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to the beautiful Annette. You know, she's a lot kinder than I am. I used to feel sorry. I really did. But we can't feel sorry anymore for you Trump supporters, because we've been talking, right? You know, I mean, it's good to have compassion. It really is. And actually, I do somewhat feel sorry. I'll be honest. But for the sake of what we're doing right here, right now, in this moment, you Trump supporters, you've gotten ample warning. We've told you over and over, day in and day out, that Donald Trump is a liar. He is, as this photo suggests, the very best of the grifters, right? So if you, at this point in time, have ran into Zeus, you've talked to me on social media and heard this truth, you've heard what my friends and the panelists have all said, hey, yo behind still ends up in a bind behind Donald Trump, to hell you go. I don't care. Enjoy it. Jail, listen, don't get into jail. You know this guy, Biggs. You hear him on Alex Jones. He was on Alex Jones a couple of days ago talking about how nasty the food in jail is, how they treat him. And I'm sitting there going, you knucklehead. We were telling you jail is not a fun place to be. Where did you get the idea that going to jail was fun from? Don't get into jail and start crying, talking about you're innocent. This is a witch hunt. The food is bad. I guarantee you, if you ask them now, listen, if you could go back in time, Mr. Biggs, if you could go back in time, right? And Tiffany, you're right. I think the pandemic did a lot of harm to the MAGA mind, because they had nothing else to do besides go protest, right? Or not protest, but go participate in an insurrection. They were bored. They were on their cell phones, consuming a lot of nasty Facebook and Twitter content, okay? And they slipped, fell, stumbled, and woke up, and they looked up, and they were in Washington, D.C., believing Donald Trump carrying these Confederate flags, shouting, hang Mike Pence. So I get it. That's how the pandemic got them, all right? And so along those lines, they ignored the warning signs that this was not going to end well for them. And now they're in a bit of a bind. You know, what they got to eat in jail, they got to eat those nasty boiled eggs, that nasty milk and that old rotten fruit. They got to share a cell. Oh, yeah. You know what they're dealing with. And they could have avoided it if they would have listened to all of us, right? All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Bambo. How are you doing, Bambo?
Well, I turned 63 yesterday.
Oh, we got to sing happy birthday to you.
Oh, thank you.
So happy birthday. Happy
well,
birthday.
Yes, it was a nice birthday. I'm for my birthday wish, I wanted everybody to donate to the guy in my PayPal, in my bio. He's a soldier, and I watched a missile just miss him. Oh my gosh. Wow. Yeah. every day. So I'm trying to help him keep a truck on the road. But anyways,
Tiffany, we got to celebrate yours.
I watched a lot of what was going on, and I just want to say thank you for the happy birthdays, guys. So I just want to say, you know, to you people who are threatening civil war and all that, you know, I look at war every day, and if you care about your country and you care about children and you care about women, that's the last thing you want to do. You want to use your head, you know. And I read another article that's really important, and that is we have to call out the supremacy. We have to start using the words that TikTok will allow us. I don't know how, but we have to really seriously call out the supremacy.
Amen. And
everybody, I can't march, you know. I have lung disease, so I can't march, but I'll tell you what, I can get a folding chair. I can get my folding chair, and I can be a folding chair brigade and sit there, and I'm telling you what, you guys want to talk that way, you're going to be surprised how many of us don't follow you. We're not going to follow you, and you've primed yourself for the next evil, because there's always going to be somebody looking to take our country down.
Yeah.
Always. And that's what you're doing, Mega. You're looking to take our country down out of fear.
And what are they afraid of? What do you think they're afraid of, Bamba?
Being marginalized or getting what's their due. You know, it's like, you know what? Would just admit your fears and come out and tell people your fears, people will turn around and say to you, you don't have nothing to fear. You know, we care about you. You know, just put down your hatred and find love. I mean, because it's out here.
There's love.
For being a boomer, I'm thankful. I am so thankful for the social media because you give me hope. You give me hope.
Who does?
Every day, you do.
Oh, I do?
And all your followers, yes.
Thank you.
You give me hope because I could croak tomorrow and I know our country and our world's in good hands. And there's not going to be a nuclear, you know, war, guys. You know
not
what?
At all.
You know, NATO doesn't need to use nuclear weapons. Even if Putin did, which he's, you know, he's been called a dead man walking. Even if he did, we would not respond in kind because we don't need to. We don't need to. No, and we have people in this country that know we don't need to. Just like we don't need to go to civil war.
Nope.
So I want to thank you. I want to thank you.
You're welcome.
There's a lot of good people out there. And I wouldn't have met you without social media.
You wouldn't have, right? Hello,
Kim. No, and I've learned so much.
Well, thank you, Bamba. I've known you since I've been on this app. You've seen the evolution. So, yes, this has been definitely
I'm a quick study.
Yeah.
All right.
I appreciate it. Now, are you going to hang out for a bit? Because before this live ends, you know, you're amongst family, and we have to sing happy birthday to you.
All right, so
give me your dog.
Thank you. And please check my bio out because, oh my God, you guys, you know, I saw war up close and personal. I can't share the video.
Right.
And I'm telling you what, and he's smiling afterwards. I mean, he's smiling, and his car kept rolling, so he stayed alive. He said the car kept him alive, but that one's gone. So, he's in special forces, so he is. He's just him and another guy, you know what I mean? And they're doing it. It's freaking scary, guys.
Wow.
I can't imagine anybody.
I take your word.
Why would we want that on this country? Why would we want that?
Well, when you got that MAGA demon, you're not thinking logically. You're not thinking rationally. And this is the problem with these Trump supporters, you know.
Right.
Like, thank you for that subscription. But all right, Bamba, what I'm going to do I'm going to bring up a few more panelists, and then I'll bring you back up again, all right? So we can sing happy birthday. And in this show on a high note, and thank you, Ladies
thank
and
you.
Gentlemen.
No, thank you. Thank no, all welcome. Of you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You have yeah. quite, you have a lot of friends out here, Bamba, all right?
Thank you. I'm a blessed boomer.
Yes, you really are. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give Bamba a round of applause. It's her birthday. We're going to sing happy birthday in a sec. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Oh, yeah, go down.
I'll drop you. Okay, I'll drop you. Hold on, we got a few more pounds, and then we'll get there. By the way, I saw the dissension in the ranks. I did. I've told you Trump supporters all the time, if you do not like this level of truth in this live, you don't have to be here. Listen to your leader.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave. As far as I'm concerned, if you hate our country,
and you do.
If you're not happy here, you can leave. If you're not happy in the U.S., if you're complaining all the time, very simply, you can leave. You can leave right now. Come back if you want. Don't come back. It's okay too. But if you're not happy, you can leave.
You hear that? If you're not happy under President Biden's regime, get to stepping. All right? Don't let the door hit you where the good Lord should have split you, right? And I saw somebody ask, what has Biden done to help, you know, minorities, you know, get jobs and things like that? I want to answer that question. You know, I have a list of all of President Biden's accomplishments. Well, most of them. And I want to make sure you know this. President Biden has achieved historically low unemployment rates after the pandemic caused them to skyrocket. Nearly 3.5% unemployment rate, the lowest in 50 years. A near record low unemployment rate for Hispanics. A near record low unemployment rate for African Americans. Record unemployment rate, low unemployment rate for folks with disabilities. You know, Donald Trump was supposed to pass infrastructure during his administration. You do know that, right? But he didn't do it. He couldn't do it. The only successful, and it's not even successful, the only legislation you could look at Trump and say he passed was the ridiculous tax cut, which we all see increased the national debt. Outside of that, you Trump supporters, Donald Trump has no idea how to be a successful president. He couldn't even... If you put his list up against President Biden's list, you really reconsider your support of Donald Trump. I know it. You can't be that ridiculous. Yeah, no health care. He was supposed to repeal and replace it. Did he repeal it and replace it? No. If you Trump supporters are, you know, if all you Trump supporters that have health care coverage, you need to be thanking President Barack Obama. All right? You should give President Obama his flowers now. Because without Obama passing the Affordable Care Act, or as I like to call it, Obamacare, Obama, Barack Hussein, Obamacare, you wouldn't be over here crying on TikTok about the price of prescription drugs. You wouldn't be doing that. You'd be in a lot worse of a situation. You'd be begging President Biden to do something. So stop listening to Donald Trump, you Trump supporters. And wake up. Stop listening to Ron DeSantis and wake up and understand the people that are helping you are the Democrats, all right? The people that are taking advantage of you are the Republicans, aka Donald Trump. When was the last time President Biden asked you folks to send him some money? And yet, and still, he keeps delivering for you. Every day you wake up, you got Donald Trump in your inbox, asking you to send him a couple of dollars. Listen, I need to go buy something around the corner right now. Can I get a couple of dollars off you? You know, that's how Donald Trump talks. Every day he needs something. He's trying to push something else on you. Oh, I got this. Come on over here. I got this for you. I could give it to you, but you got to give me a couple of dollars. Don't you see this? The man's treating you like you're addicted. He's treating you like you're the addict and he's your drug man. He's the pusher. Donald Trump is the MAGA pusher. I need to go ahead and play that song. I'm your pusher, man. Don't I need to play that, right? Donald Trump is the MAGA demon pusher, man. This man wakes up pushing MAGA demon like it's new It's the newest product on the block. I mean, I've never seen a dope. I can't even say it on TikTok. I've never seen anyone push this hard in my life. This man wakes up. Actually, I don't know when Trump sleeps, but starting around 9 p.m. at night, Donald Trump gets onto social media and starts bombarding you all with that MAGA dope. It's MAGA dope. It's this MAGA demon possessed stuff. And he's selling it harder than anyone I've ever seen. I mean, he got 20 out of you yesterday. You know what? I need 40 out of you today. I got 40 out of you. I need $100 out of you today. And I'm not stopping until you send it. All right? And I'm, you don't got it. What? How much do you got? I can work with you. How much do you got? You're on Social Security? I don't care. Send it to me. This is how Donald Trump is. And yet and still, you would wear Donald Trump boxers in a men's locker room. What a shame. Something's wrong with your mind. Something's wrong with you Trump supporters' mind. I tell you, you cannot make this stuff up. Oh, okay. All right, Dionysius, you're back. Welcome. How are you doing this morning?
How's it going, brother?
I'm all right. How are you?
Been all right. So, like, this is what type of man Biden is, or has become, let's say. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, everybody knows about his history back in the day when he was younger in parks. But I think his time after the Obama family and experiencing a family like that made him realize that some of his views weren't right, and he had to do something to make up for it.
Right.
And this is exactly that. He said the only reason he was run is to keep what he had established, and I don't think that had anything to do with the first 30-something years of his career.
Right.
I think that had to do with the very last. He did not want to. He wanted to retire and go home happy and elderly and trip on stairs, not Air Force Ones. Like, I trip all the time. But this is what he's probably going to do. He's not like Donald Trump, where he's going to allow his, even like, if, especially if they're not true, but drama involved around him to engulf the country in division. So what I think he's going to do, like a proper leader does, he's going to step down, allow somebody that isn't engulfed in any type of conspiracy or anything, and he's going to go be happy, because I think he I think he knows that Gen Z and Gen Alpha are going to put the final nail in the coffin of the GOP.
Yeah.
And all your people are right up on the panel today. Like, we don't need to fight one another. Like, just drop the Labor Day, and just, like, if you see somebody that's having a hard day, just, like, maybe go have a conversation. See if they need food, air, and water.
Yeah.
And if they're human.
Yeah. Good morning, Andy.
And people who are planning on that civil type of stuff, I would probably, so the country's turning around, but we still have all these open federal penitentiaries and prisons, right?
Right.
And they have to be filled. Right now, they're filled with 80% nonviolent offenders that are most likely going to be, because of their nonviolence, they're going to have to replace that industry. And I know you guys pride yourself on being such good 9-to-5 workers and driving trucks. They are just begging for people like you in the prison industry. They would love to fill the places with people like you, because I think you guys would like it too. You'd all be in one spot. It's really not that bad once you get in a routine, and you guys are all about routines. You kind of like animals.
Yeah.
And one more thing. Bigfoot,
you raise these
Bigfoot's
animals.
Bigfoot's upset because you're comparing him to MAGA.
Mm.
All right, Bigfoot is far more intelligent, far more compassionate, far more human, and he would like if you could replace that thing with a troll.
With a troll? Okay.
Yeah, a troll.
Well, who said that was Bigfoot? I didn't Bigfoot, but you're right.
All right, brother.
All right.
Have a good one.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dionysius, welcome. No lies detected. And I saw a comment in there about someone saying Donald Trump hasn't done anything to children. I'm going to encourage you to go revisit your sources. Or thank you, Greg, because that's not true. Donald Trump has a nasty track record. All right, he's not as clean as you think he is. But you got to go look this stuff up. There are docket numbers behind the stuff Trump does.
All right. So listen up, Trump supporters. You know the rules. If you're going to accuse somebody, thank you, Angela. If you're going to accuse someone, you have to have the docket number. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, let's bring up my good friend, the beautiful Shay.
Hey, 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 everybody. Hey, hey, hey.
Oh, my gosh. Can we talk about a couple of things? You know, did y'all see that group of schmozzies outside of Disney World?
I did. I saw. Uh-huh. Yes. Yeah. They said they'd vote for Biden, too.
Oh, did they? I didn't hear that. I heard they weren't going to vote for Trump because, you know, he has a Jewish daughter.
Or maybe I'm talking about a different one. There was two of them, I think. There may have been, I don't know which one.
Yeah, you're not going to vote for Biden, that's for sure. But no, this group was yelling for DeSantis. And he said, no, we support DeSantis. We support DeSantis. And you know who hasn't condemned these people yet?
Who?
DeSantis. He hasn't come out, made a statement at all. So Florida has become a breeding ground of white supremacists. Yeah, I've seen flags of the Crooked Cross hanging over. I mean, everything's happening in Florida, and that's because of Ron DeSantis. Mm. Because when you can have an outright attack on Black history,
right?
You know, all these things and trying to overturn everything, it's absolutely gloves off for these people. And that's what they were doing. And DeSantis has said nothing. He's not condemned them. He's not come out strongly, said they shouldn't exist.
Right.
It's wow. And the other thing is, he didn't meet with Joe Biden.
Isn't that something? Mm-hmm. He would meet with all the other devils, mm-hmm. but he won't meet with an upstanding president like President Biden.
Absolutely. And you know who did though? Rick Scott. Rick Scott met with Joe Biden and gave Joe Biden credit. Do you know what Joe Biden did? As Adelia was about to hit the shores, he released all FEMA. Got everything activated, all the funds necessary before the hurricane even hit Florida. Now that's a real. Yeah.
That's my president. That's my president. That's MAGA's president too.
Absolutely. It really is. And the thing with the train derailment and stuff like that, there were zero deaths in that. Zero deaths. And he sent people in to help with the cleanup. He doesn't have to go every single place. He'll go where there's really awful moments of, you know, tragedy and things like that. So, I mean, that's the way to do things. But their own governor wasn't even there. I mean, I'm sitting here going, but no wonder he's sinking so terribly in the polls.
Yeah.
I mean, at least they're kind of getting that. But the fact that he has as much support as he does is pretty disgusting. Yeah,
you're right.
Can we talk about Burning Man?
Oh, talk about it. I heard about that too.
So here's the deal. So there's been climate change protesters at the entry gate to Burning Man, right? So there's been all these protests, you know, climate change is, you know, really this and that, and you guys are wearing down the resources. This is native property, all of this, and be forcing them out and running them down and trying to get them to stop protesting. Well, then they held this, you know, this Burning Man concert or whatever. It's kind of like a what's that hippie festival in the 70s, what I'm thinking of. It'll come to me. Y'all help me out. Y'all know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I think
it's one
of
the 70s. It was one of those things. And I was just like, okay.
Woodstock, yeah.
Woodstock. Thank you. I love you people. There you go. Thank you. Thank you. Woodstock. So it's kind of like a Woodstock, right? And so they're out there. And guess what happens? Have the most amount of rainfall that has ever happened on recorded history that flooded them in so bad. 72,000 partygoers, basically, concert goers, are stuck. I mean, make that make sense.
Yeah.
Make
you
that
still don't believe there's
no climate change, right? I mean, it's so, y'all, this is so, I mean, I don't want to laugh because I felt for those people that got stuck and the porta potties were bad and their mud. I mean, yeah, it's awful, but it's the hypocrisy for me. It's the God saying, ha, you laugh now, watch this. You know,
you laugh.
What in the world?
We got something for that. We got something for you. You think it's funny? We got something for you.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just sitting here going, yeah, it's total karma, exactly. I'm just like, okay, so this is what we're dealing with, right? And of course, Marjorie Taylor Greene wants to say that, you know, there's all these people dying and all this stuff. I'm not like, what are you doing? Like, stop.
Yeah.
Oh, they're just stuck in the mud, but they're able to get out today.
That That's a good way to describe MAGA. Stuck in the mud, right? That's
stuck in the mud. More are they ever. Yeah. Are they ever? And please tell me, this is so funny. Have you heard about Truth Social?
Uh-uh.
So looks like they're about to go bankrupt. So the
Why am I not surprised?
So that is his own social app is failing. So that's going under. And you heard about Letitia James, right? That's looking pretty bad. Looks like possibly a judge is going to pick up that case and make a decision, which will possibly cost him $250 million.
And he won't be allowed to do business in the state of New York, right?
Oh, exactly. Exactly.
Let me ask you, he threw his own son under the bus.
Yes,
he should. They're all grifters and criminals. So, yeah, he can point to anyone in his family and they're guilty. You know, they all should point back at him. But one last question before I leave, you know, Snuggles, or before we move on, because we gotta sing happy birthday to Bamba. Oh,
yes, we do.
Okay. Can I ask you a question? Mm-hmm. You heard Trump org got 17 convictions. Have you heard about that?
No, I had heard about that.
Yeah. What are your, do you think that is Trump org connected to Donald Trump in any way? Because there's a rumor going around that Donald Trump had nothing to do with Trump org, and it was just his CFO.
Really?
So I want to make sure we get these convictions correct and we apply it to whoever is in charge of this company. So is the CFO in charge of it, or is Trump in charge of it?
I believe Trump is the CEO, which Trump's the CFO.
Oh. So,
you know, if you know anything about corporate politics, you understand that the actual CEO and president, who is Donald J. Trump, is actually head of it. So therefore, he knew everything that was going on. He absolutely did. And Weissman was willing to be thrown out of the bus and go to prison for this man. But that's all on Weissman.
Mm.
I mean, it's just tumbling down around him, and he's just screaming for help.
Yeah.
He's just screaming for help. Like,
impeach
Biden now. What is that going to do? If Biden gets impeached, every single American will know that was highly political. And then he's not going to get removed. So how is that? It's not going to affect him at all, because they're not going to show any proof of any kind of anything. Like,
And it also just puts Kamala Harris right there. If they do convict him in the Senate, it just puts Kamala Harris in the president.
Exactly. Which I know that for real, I don't even think y'all will impeach him just because of that. Y'all don't want a black woman as your president. Trust. You know, they're going to sit there and go, well, I mean, I need to impeach him for my political butt to be saved, but then I don't want a black woman to be president. I can't. No. I mean, these poor people.
Once again, Sleepy Joe outsmarted MAGA, right? I mean, you know, he had to know when he picked her as his vice president. He had that in mind.
Yeah, he did.
He outsmarted.
That's a safety zone.
MAGA, you are silly. All right, Shay, we got to bring up our panelists. All right. Thank you, and have a great Labor Day.
Happy birthday, Bamba. All right, love you, sir. Right. Bye.
Love you too, ladies and gentlemen. Bushmaster, it doesn't matter what people call you; it's what you respond to. And last I checked, Kamala Harris and President Biden, you know, they are what we like to call winners. Can you spell winners? Oh my god. I gotta talk to Miss Warrior. Welcome.
Good morning.
Hello. Good morning.
Hi. Good morning, Zeus.
Hello. Thank you for hanging in there. All right. And how are you doing?
I'm good.
Happy Labor Day. All right. You got any plans today?
No, nothing really. Just going to relax.
Okay. Hey, that's better than most people, all right? I know a lot of people that are still getting up and getting to it.
Absolutely. So I don't know if you have to ask me my questions or not. I've never been up here before, but that's okay if you don't.
No, well, listen, we're friends, but you said you've never been up here, so you know what this requires. I got to ask some questions, all right?
Because yes. How you answer them determines your fate in the kingdom. Fair enough?
Yes, fair.
All right. All right. So, first question. In your opinion, was the 2020 election stolen by President Joseph Biden?
No.
All right. Next question. In your opinion, who would you say is responsible for the attack on the Capitol on January 6th?
I would say Trump.
Hey! Good answers. All right. Well, okay, I got to give you my last and final question. And it's going to come at you like a curveball, right? I think you might get it right. I think you might get it right, but, you know, a lot of people, they get it wrong. And if you get it wrong, Zeus is going to have to drop you from the box, Miss Warrior, all right?
I get you. Okay.
Okay. I know we're good friends, but I don't like people taking advantage of my kindness, all right? Now, in your opinion, is President Biden or Hillary Clinton guilty of any crime?
No.
Hey! Welcome to the kingdom. All right.
Thank you.
You did a great job. You told the truth and shamed the devil. All right. And I'm so honored to have you. So
thank you.
What do you got for us this lovely Labor Day morning?
So I just wanted to make a point. You brought this up earlier, and I know somebody else did, but why is it that MAGA thinks that Biden isn't doing anything? Well, because the man is stealth.
Oh.
The man, how many times has the man complained or criticized or even mentioned Trump's name since he became president? Probably less than 10 times. He doesn't comment on the investigations. He doesn't comment about, oh, this man is corrupt. He doesn't say anything. The man keeps his head down and just does his job. And notice that when you go into these MAGA areas, they are the loudest ones. It's like they have to scream the loudest. They have to talk over us. And just like Trump, he's the loudest man in this country, and he gets nothing done. So I'm putting my money on the stealth man.
Yeah.
No one hears what he's doing. He doesn't complain. He doesn't criticize. He just does his job, and he doesn't make excuses if things don't work out. The other thing I wanted to bring up, Zeus, is a lot of times when I'm in these lives, I like to tell MAGA people to go read a book, because I'm a teacher, and it's really important to me that people educate themselves. But I'm going to change that mantra starting right now. Instead of me saying read a book, I'm going to suggest that someone read a book to them. Because just like a toddler has not yet learned how to read. So mom and dad and Auntie M have to read the book to them. So starting right here on this live, my new mantra is find an adult to read a book to you and learn from them.
Tell them they're quiet.
That's all I have.
We're doing their homework for them day in and day out, and yet they're kicking and screaming at us, right?
Yep. It's like my students, the ones that complain the loudest about the amount of homework I give and how hard the class is, they're the ones that aren't doing anything anyway. It's always the quietest students that put their head down and do their job that have the most success in my classes. Yep. And I have to compare MAGA to those loud students that don't do the work. They complain. Okay, Zeus, I'm out of here. I just wanted to jump up. I love your content. I love this live. Big fan, and happy Labor Day. Keep the good fight up. You're doing a great job, okay?
All right, and you as well, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get
Thank you.
Ms. Warrior.
Thank you. Can you help me out of the box? I can't. Okay, I got it. Thank you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to round the corner. Zeus has to. Oh, I gotta bring up my last and final panelist before I wrap it up. We gotta sing "Happy Birthday" to Bamba and wrap this live up. Wow, I went well over my 1.5 hour. Good morning, Lisa. How are you doing?
It's actually pronounced Missa, but good morning to you.
Missa. Okay, Missa. Good morning. How are you?
I am fantastic. That's not a problem. It's a weird name.
Well, listen, it's a beautiful name. I just haven't been used to using it, all right? But I'm going to get used to using it. How are you doing this morning?
I am just happy to be enjoying this day that liberals brought to you.
Thank you.
We fought hard and we got it. This is the day for labor, and labor gets a day off.
Right, and that's a good point to make sure we amplify.
Mm-hmm.
Out here benefiting from this day, right? They're getting the day off. They're hanging out, doing God knows what, but they don't know why they're able to do it. And you're making it very clear to them.
I like to remind people that a lot of things that they enjoy were brought to you by liberals.
Mm-hmm.
It's conservatives that don't want to bring these things to you.
Right.
Like the 5-day work week.
Mm.
Unions did so much for people, and MAGA hates unions because they were told to hate unions.
Wow. Yeah.
I'm a union member. I actually am a letter carrier for the United States Postal Service, and I am proud. I am proud to be a federal employee, just like one in every 12 Americans.
Nice. Wow. Congratulations.
And I actually just wanted to come up and say I enjoy listening to your lives in the morning while I'm at work. You're right next to my, in my pocket, right next to my chest, and you keep me company. I appreciate it.
Thank you. It's nice to know that I'm keeping you company while you're making money in Biden's economy. Wow. Thank you so much. All right. I mean, any plans today before you wrap it up?
Honestly, I just want to rest because I do have I actually have two jobs. I bartend on Sunday, so this is my day to rest.
Oh, wow. Yes, please get some rest. Oh, my God. How do you do it? You bartend on Sundays?
I like to sock money away from my extravagant vacations.
Oh, okay. Listen, as long as you're happy and healthy doing what you do, more power to you. You know, and by the way, you got two jobs. That's like, you know, again, you're helping with Biden's historically low unemployment rate, right? So give yourself a round of applause. Yeah. All right,
I didn't want to take up too much of your time. I just wanted to thank you for what you do.
All right. Well, listen, I thank you for all you're doing and those kind words of encouragement. All right.
Appreciate it.
Keep up.
You have a great day.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, Mista, let's give her a round of applause. I hope I said it right. You got to tell me how to say it right if I'm not getting it right.
All right, how do I get out of here?
I got you. All right. Let's bring up. Oh, hold on. Let me see if I got you. All right. Let me see. All right. Well, listen, ladies and gentlemen, listen, we've reached that point in the live where Zeus must depart and tend to other affairs in the kingdom. But I hope we all learned something very important this lovely Labor Day. All right. This lovely Labor Day morning. One, President Biden will be giving a speech today. All right. Where at? In Philadelphia. All right. Part of the Labor Day parade. So if you get a chance, please make sure you tune in and watch it. We've also learned once again that every MAGA accusation is truly a MAGA confession, right? We've learned that. We've learned that the real election interference is not coming from President Biden at all, but it's coming from Donald Trump, who is trying to make Americans pay at the pump,
with the gas prices, all right? He's working with MBS over there in Saudi Arabia to cut the production and jack up those gas prices to make us all suffer. But it's not going to work because the American people, we voted once and we'll vote again. We voted once and we'll vote again to keep Donald John Trump out of that White House. All right, now before I get out of here, you know what we got to do. Bamba, are you there? Bamba, are you there? If you're there, Bamba, please send a guest request. It is now time to sing our good friend Bamba a happy birthday. Cut it out, Nutty. Cut it out. Bamba, I don't see you in the guest box. It's time for you to get in the box. We're going to sing happy birthday, and then we're going to wrap this show up, all right? Someone please tell Bamba to get in the box. All right. All right. There she is, ladies and gentlemen. All right. You know what we do. All right. I love doing the birthday shout outs. All right.
So yes. Thank you.
Wow. If you're part of the kingdom, please send birthday. Let us know it's your birthday. All right. So
thank you.
Let's get it going, ladies and gentlemen.
I heard it was somebody's birthday. I heard it was somebody's birthday. Yeah, PJ Panda birthday song. Yeah, yeah. Today is your birthday. We don't say it loud. Today is your birthday. I need a surprise.
Hey.
Oh no, not big.
Oh. Oh yeah. Let's go. And it's lit.
Believe I'm doing this.
Yes, oh, this is TikTok, baby.
I never show my face.
It's an honor. Turn up.
Blue, blue.
Hey. Hey. Hey, LJ. Yes, ladies!
Thank you, everybody. Oh my God. Whoa! Thank you. Wow. I've never gone big on the face in the box. Oh.
I know. What an amazing birthday experience, right? This is our first
Yeah, that was like humbling.
Looking beautiful and gorgeous. Oh my
God. Oh, thank you. Oh.
You took the shine away from Zeus, man. But I mean, what an amazing
No.
Huh? All right.
No, that app where it says how old do I look? I don't dare touch that. I don't touch that.
The app is listen, you gotta touch it, all right? And again,
I just look the same.
Tell them. You look 25 if you ask all of us, all right, Bamba? So cut it out. Cut it out, Bamba, all right. All right, well, listen up, Bamba. Thank you so much. I hope
having me.
Anytime.
You have a great day.
All right, you too. Ladies
look
and gentlemen.
Look for love.
Yes, look for love. All right. Well, that concludes today's show. Happy Labor Day, everyone. And we are officially out of here. Take care. Stay safe out there. And don't get into any nonsense, all right? All right, Mrs. Silk, I see you. Good morning. Hold on. Have a great rest of your morning.
I'll move when I'm walking like Zeus.
This is how I stare when I'm talking like Zeus. This is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus.
I like to act a fool when I'm looking like Zeus. Great show, everyone! Reggie! Angela! Funny girl! My mom, yes! Look at Rick! Jenna! Darkstreet! Angela! I can't leave it up to you! Elvin! Laura! Meg! Oh my god! Nemo! Buchanan! Queen, please! Christy! Tyrone, yo! Hey! Oh! Politically, hey! Angela, wow! Homer, welcome! Tiffany for the people, yes! You know I'm so handsome, that's why they call me Zeus! Little Hot! Mommy! You're welcome, Laura. Angela, you're so kind. You really are. I make my own rules. I'm a god. Call me Zeus.
I'm hotter than Hades and I'm burning down the roof.
All right, I'll take it. Now, Nigo.
I got a cue.
Dark handsome dude.
Yeah. Me be cool. I'm just sitting on my throne.
Why like you looking like a goof?
Trying to let loose with the truth. Yeah, grab your goose.
Hey, little mama, let me play with your caboose. I know the ladies love me because I'm shooting like a tooth.
Play hating on the gods, boy, you're such a bitch. Try to be patient, but you had
to be. I did, yeah.
Yes, I had a mother. Yeah, I'm the one that they choose. You know I'm so handsome.
Triple C.
When I'm walking like Zeus, this is how I sound when I'm talking like Zeus. This is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus. I like to act a fool when I'm moving like Zeus. Don't be playing with my mood when I'm moving like Zeus.
Okay.
Keeping it cool till I'm moving like Zeus. Thunder in the sky like
DJ, little Zeus. Hog, get him.
Rules, oh my god, call me Zeus.
Yeah, you know about me.
I
like to get wild and Zeus.
Freddy,
I'm the goddess of God, you know what I'm saying? I'll bring it down the roof.
I just want to find